Once a man is diagnosed with a prostate cancer that needs to be treated, how does he make a decision on which path to go, and the surgery or the radiation? So when a man is diagnosed with a localized prostate cancer that we think needs to be treated, and those are the markers help us, and the Gleason score helps us. But if they have a lot of cancer, they have two or three biopsies that are positive, and they're intermediate grade cancer, seven. Their PSA's 5 to 7 or so, and we decide that we're going to treat that patient. There's things that there's surgery, radiation. We talked a little bit about cryotherapy and HIFU, but the two main ones are surgery and radiation. And how does a guy choose between surgery and radiation? A lot of times I tell him, listen, the difference in outcome most of the time between surgery and radiation, at least survival rate, it's basically the same. They just have, different complications, different short-term and different long-term complications. And there's no free ride. So if somebody tells you I can treat you and you're going to be a better man than you are right now, that's not true. So with surgery, there's different ways to do it. And again, it's the person doing it, not the technique that matters so much. Basically what I do is I have people come into the hospital. We do it through a very small 7-centimeter incision. Don't have people donate any blood. It's rare that we have to do that, like one in the last or two in the last 1,000 patients I've done. The operation takes 2 hours. You go home the next day. A tube is left in. You get out. That gets out in a couple of weeks, and you get back to activities. Okay, that's wonderful. And if you have a cancer confined to your prostate, which if we select the right patients, most of them do. Side effects, impotence and incontinence. Incontinence means you leak urine. Again, depending on the patient's age and where they are, the risk of incontinence, total incontinence, can be anywhere from less than 1% to 4%. Stress incontinence means you cough, sneeze, bear down, lose urine. That's, again, 4 to 5%. And the impotence is related to age, tumor, skills, various other things like that. So, return of potency can be anywhere from 20% to 85 to 90%, depending on the age and other factors. So those are the two big I's. Radiation has similar side effects, impotence and incontinence. Radiation is delivered over 6 to 7 weeks, 5 days a week. If you use external beam, people are using CyberKnife and other ways to cut that down. It's still investigational, but some very good data that are emerging. Seed implants, you get those, you go home. But they have side effects. They all have side effects, and they're impotence and incontinence. And the incontinence you get with radiation is different than surgery. It's urge incontinence. In other words, you're sitting or standing talking to somebody, and you got to go. And if you don't go to the bathroom, you leak. Whereas stress incontinence you get from surgery is more like you cough, sneeze, bear down, and lose urine. Impotence with radiation is about the same as surgery. It just takes a while to develop because of damage to small blood vessels and nerves over a period of time from the radiation. And then there's some long-term side effects of radiation, including second cancers and rectal bleeding and things like that can occur years later. So a lot of people say, well, if you're younger, you should get surgery. If you're older, radiation, because the side effects are balanced out with that. That doesn't necessarily mean you shouldn't have radiation if you're younger. I think you just have to have an honest discussion with your doctor. And best thing to do is go to places where they have multidisciplinary clinics, where there's just not one-stop shopping. It's just not surgery, or it's just not radiation, where you get a balanced view.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed, but right now a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.